Our mapper code creates variables that we will use to create columns within our database. When we create a column, we must also pass in attributes of that column. Here are some column attributes that we will be using in the activities in Lesson 1. We can specify a string with a specified maximum string length, and we can specify integers, which are handy for storing whole number values. Relationships tell SQL Alchemy the type of relationship one table has to another. Nullable is an attribute that, if set to false, indicates that a column entry must have a value in order for the row to be created. Setting primary key to true indicates a value that we can use to uniquely identify each row of our database table. And foreign key we can use to reference a row in a different table, provided that a relation exists between the two of them. Inside each restaurant class, for now we're just going to specify a name and an ID number to reference each restaurant. We create a variable and name it name, specify it as a column, say that this column has a string with a maximum length of 80 characters, and set nullable equal to false, indicating that if name is not filled out, we cannot create a new restaurant row in this database. Similarly, we'll create a variable called ID, which we'll also specify as a column, but this time we'll say it's an integer instead of a string, and set primary key to true. Our menu items are going to have a little bit more information. Just like each restaurant, each menu item needs to have a name. We'll set nullable equal to false again to make sure that no one can create a menu item without a name. We'll create an ID for each menu item, which is set to the primary key. We'll create course, description, and price variables, and specify them all as strings. I'm now going to create a variable called restaurant underscore ID, and specify this as a foreign key integer. This will create the foreign key relationship between my menu item class and my restaurant class. Inside the foreign key, I specify restaurant.id. This will say, look inside the restaurant table and retrieve the ID number whenever I ask for restaurant underscore ID. And this last line, I'm creating a variable called lowercase restaurant, which I'm saying is the relationship between my class restaurant.